Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 15th August, on the front page you have court acquits six accused in Pehlu Khan lynching case. So this is session judge which has given them the benefit of doubt. The Rajasthan government has filed an appeal against this acquittal. So here you can see it was 2 years ago that Haryana dairy farmer Pehlu Khan was allegedly lynched by a mob of cow vigilants on the Jaipur-Delhi National Highway. The session court in Alwar has acquitted all the six persons accused of beating him to death while giving them the benefit of doubt. So this is a 2017 incident here, detailed out. Then this is Trump repeats threat to take US out of WTO. So President Donald Trump questions developing tag for China and India, and he says that he may take US out of World Trade Organization, which is the world's largest multilateral trade forum. So here you can see the developed and developing countries listed, as well as least developed countries which are listed under WTO. So India, China, Russia, Brazil, South Africa, South Korea are called developing countries. Developed are US, European Union, Japan, Canada, Australia, New Zealand. And the least developed are also listed here, like, you know, our neighbors to Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Myanmar, Nepal, South Sudan. So you can see. So here, this is the point of concern for US President Donald Trump, that why India and China are developing countries. On page 9, you have Swachh to look beyond toilets. So this is open defecation free plus phase, which will focus on waste management now under the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So it will focus on solid and liquid waste management. So you can see it includes prevalence of plastic litter and waterlogging in villages as indicators of cleanliness in the 2019 rural survey. Then this is government set to ease norms for mining. So Union Environment Ministry plans to provide temporary forest clearances to prospective bidders for mines whose leases are set to expire in March 2020. So bulk of such mines are located in Orissa and Karnataka. So it says this will avoid a dip in iron production. Some relaxation will be provided to them, you can see. Temporary forest clearance. On the editorial page, the first editorial is symptoms as cause. So this is regarding the auto sales. Automobile sales have fallen. So it says this reflects a pervasive lack of demand. So this is the symptom that there is lack of demand. So that is the point highlighted in this editorial. The second editorial, unethical actions. So this is regarding the mass detention of MLAs that make a mockery of democracy in Sikkim. So switching of sides by 10 MLAs from Sikkim, Democratic Front, to Bharatiya Janata Party in Sikkim, and later two others also shifted. So this brings a sense of deja vu. This similar thing has happened in other states also. That is a point put forth here. These are unethical ways in which MLAs shift political parties after being elected to the house. And the lead article is Assam's humanitarian conundrum. So it says neither Delhi nor Dispur, means neither the capital, central government, nor the state government of Assam has been working on a proper plan for those who will soon be declared stateless. So the deadline for final NRC to be published is 31st August now. So that is the point highlighted here. Then this is a playing field for political violence. So this is how history offers a narrative on why it is so entrenched in Bengal, irrespective of political affiliation. So West Bengal as such, or Bengal in general, witnesses large-scale political violence. So why is it so that, you know, Bengal is so entrenched with this political violence, irrespective of political affiliation? So that point is discussed here. We have seen attacks on political leaders, you know, political representatives in West Bengal, be they of Trinamool Congress or of BJP or others. So on the editorial page, these two editorials as such, which are from the editor's desk, so these two are important. And this is called the lead article and the article below it. These two articles, like this, is about Assam's NRC. So this has been covered up quite often, so you may or may not go into details of this. So this is fine. So there are three categorizations we can say about articles, which we'll see in editorial page on in newspapers every day. ones are those of issues which are in news, so they are relevant, but then they may not be important because we are covering it in some way or the other, so you don't need to go through whole details. So this falls in that middle category. They are relevant but not important. This is also relevant but not important. The op-ed page, the other page here, you can see the second page which is there. Here, this is an important article, envisioning Ladakh's future as union territory. So this question which is tried to be answered is, will a greater centralization of decision making help the region's already fragile terrain? So what will be the future of Ladakh? What are the consequences of the decision which has been taken to make Ladakh into a union territory? So that is discussed here. So this is important. And this is also important. This is a reality check on India's renewable energy capacity. India has not been able to make full use of reduction in costs. So how are renewable targets are being met? What are the concerns that is covered here? So how China is way ahead of India. So this is important. Then this is about India's integration after independence. On page 12, you have Naga groups assail rethink on rain cutoff. So this is regarding the register of indigenous inhabitants of Nagaland, RIN. So this has been proposed in the state of Nagaland on the lines of an RC updation which has been done in Assam. So Nagaland government has changed the cutoff date for including people, more people in the RIN exercise. But Naga civil society groups have warned the Nagaland government against such a move. So that is discussed here. You can see it was on June 29, 2019 that Nagaland government came with a notification to decide the date of rain, the cutoff date for rain as December 1, 1963. So some organizations have demanded cutoff date should be changed to 28 April 1977. So that was the date when Nagaland became a state. So it was Nagaland which came out from the Assam state in 1977. And the 1963 date has been the one which the government has announced. Then this is also important. Veer Chakra for Wing Commander Abhinandan. So Indian Air Force personnel who were part of the February 26 Balakot airstrike on Jaish-e-Mohammed terror training camp in Pakistan and the air engagement the day after have been awarded gallantry medals on the eve of Independence Day, which includes Wing Commander Abhinandan Vardhman, who was caught by Pakistan after his MiG-21 fighter jet went down across LOC. So he was returned by Pakistan after 3 days. He has been awarded with Veer Chakra, which is the country's third highest gallantry award. And then on international page, again the news about Hong Kong protests continue. China says this is near terrorism now. Then below you have Facebook listened to users' private conversations. So this is a report which says that transcriptions were made and Facebook has paid hundreds of contractors to listen to the transcribed snippets of users' conversations. So Facebook has acknowledged that transcriptions which were first reported by Bloomberg telling the news agencies in a statement that they were made with users' permission. But the practice has nonetheless been stopped. Then this is, spies are watching our scientists, says Kremlin. So Russia says that foreign spies keen to get their hands on Russian research are monitoring Russian scientists around the clock. Business page you have, July trade deficit narrows to $13.43 billion. So overall exports in April to July rise to 3.13%, rise by 3.13%, and trend is seen as positive amid low expectations on demand. So this is trade deficit narrowing, exports have increased. And this is government asks public sector banks to find out reasons for rise in non-performing assets in last 5 years. So performance review has been set in motion by public sector banks now. And this is wholesale inflation which has also eased to 1.08% in July 2019. And below you have textile ministry signs MOU for skill training. So Union Textiles Ministry signed an MOU with 16 state governments to offer skill training programs under the Samarth scheme for capacity building in the textile sector. So this is important, Samarth scheme which will train 4 lakh people in the textile sector. Then on the last page you have eggshells used to synthesize natural bone implant material. So nano powder may replace commercially available substitutes. This is what the researchers from Indian Institute of Technology IIT Hyderabad and Dr. B. R. Ambedkar National Institute of Technology Jalandhar have developed. It's a process by which bone implant material can be synthesized from eggshells. It's bioceramics made from eggshells. They exhibit better, greater biocompatibility than other synthetic powders. And this is NASA to use lava field for Mars practice. So to prepare for the next mission to Mars in 2020, NASA has taken to the lava fields of Iceland to get its new robotic space explorer ready for the job. So this black basalt sand, windswept dunes and craggy peaks that are present in Iceland in the Lumbaron lava field in Iceland, which is the second biggest glacier near the foot of second biggest glacier of Iceland, that is Langjökull. It has been chosen as a stand-in for Mars surface. So NASA is going to experiment here. You can see NASA is planning for Mars in 2020. It will aim to continue the work of the Curiosity rover, which has been exploring Mars since 2012 in search of signs of ancient life and making preparation for human exploration. So these are the important headlines for 15th August. Thank you.